Music can change the world. These were simple, yet one of the most powerful quotes by one of the most greatest composers the world has ever seen, Ludwig van Beethoven. He was a German composer, born in Germany, and he was a well-known pianist. Right from a very young age, his genius, his prodigious talent was very evident to people around him. His first teacher was his father. His father gave him a very tough time. He used to force young Beethoven to keep playing the piano for hours together. His father felt that he had a better chance in being successful if he made it big at a very young age. He used to wake up Beethoven in the middle of the night just to make him play the piano. Most of the times, young Beethoven was left to tears. Apparently, it is said that his father fudged his age and showed his age as 6 years old when he performed the first time in a public when his true age was actually 7. Basically, his father pushed Beethoven a lot and it was a very strict disciplinarian. Beethoven had a very troubled childhood. He lost 4 of his younger brothers to tuberculosis. He lost his favorite and most dear mom also to tuberculosis when he was just 16 years old. To further complicate the matters, his father had become a great alcoholic. He had left off all the responsibilities of taking care of the family. Young Beethoven, at just 16 years of age, started taking care of his brothers and he started earning money through music. When he was 21 years old, through various acquaintances of his and through his various music teachers, he was convinced to move from Germany to Vienna in Austria. Vienna was considered as the capital of classical music at that point of time. Whenever we look back at the history of classical music, Beethoven plays a very crucial figure in the transition from the classical era to the romantic era. Story has it that Beethoven went to Vienna, he became a great composer, he composed a lot of great songs, and end of the day, he's one of the greatest composers ever lived. Of all the things from Beethoven, one thing I would like to talk to you about is one of his greatest compositions called the Ninth Symphony. Coincidentally, the Ninth Symphony was the last ever symphony he composed. What is a symphony? Symphony is basically a musical composition which consists of a lot of different instruments. Beethoven composed his Ninth Symphony for almost 2 years, but he felt that there was something missing. He wanted to basically push the limits of what was supposed to be a symphony at that point of time. And then, by an inspired move, he came up with chorus and vocals for the Ninth Symphony. This was unheard of at that time. It was May 24, 1824, 100 years before Toastmasters. This was the day, the first time the Ninth Symphony was performed in public. Beethoven was a possessed man. He behaved like a madman. He was the person who conducted the music. Basically, the conductor is someone who stands in front of the orchestra and basically conducts based on the projection or the progression of the music. Whenever the notes hit a high pitch, he raised himself to full height. Whenever the notes hit a low pitch, he almost crouched down to the floor. He used to wave his hands and legs. It was as though that he wanted to play each and every instrument which was part of the orchestra. The highlight of the orchestra was obviously the vocals and the chorus which came at the end. People were dumbfounded. They were awestruck at the brilliance of this man. There was a silence of 2 seconds or 5 seconds maybe after the composition was completed. Then slowly the applause started. One by one, everyone started applauding with so much of vigor. They started applauding and the applause, based on eyewitness accounts, went for almost 5 minutes. But the only thing or the only problem was Beethoven never faced the audience to acknowledge them. He was still facing the orchestra and looking at them. One of the vocalists had to come by to him and ask him to turn around. Dear Toastmasters, one of the greatest composers the world has ever seen, Beethoven was actually deaf. He was deaf from the year of 25 years old. Most of his famous compositions have been composed when he was actually deaf and he could not listen to his own music. People say that he used to plaster his ear on the top of the keyboard or the piano, make sure that he hears the vibration of his own compositions to make sure that he's actually convinced with whatever he's composing. Even I am a musician, nowhere close to the level of Beethoven, but I could say that there are some similarities between me and Beethoven. For example, even I love music just like Beethoven. Maybe not as much, but I do like music. just like his father, even my grandmother fudged my age so that I could skip pre-KG and directly go to LKG. But any which ways, all the similarities between Beethoven and I ends there. One of the major contributing factors for me to pursue with music is to understand how the other person feels whenever I perform. Be it in my school, be it in my college, or wherever I perform, the one major thing which is very important for me is appreciation from the audience. But here he was, Beethoven, considered as one of the greatest composers, and he could not even understand that people are trying to acknowledge him and appreciate him for his great compositions. I was mind blown. Dear Toastmasters, Beethoven's 9th symphony, I feel, is the true power of performance. Steve Jobs, in one of his interviews, goes on to say that recruiting a person for a company is actually an art. He tells that I cannot keep policing everyone 24 hours by 7. The true caliber of an employee is come out only when he performs when no one else is watching. That's a true testament to whatever Beethoven did. He never cared about all the adulations or appreciation. All he did was care about the art. All he did was care about the music. All he wanted to do was be truthful to his music, and the power of performance was there for all to see. Dear Toastmasters, all of us crave for appreciation. I don't think it's a bad thing. It's a great thing to keep us motivated. But I feel that should just be a starting point for us to go and do something beautiful in our lives. If you're a new member or doing something in office, or a new student doing something in your maybe a music class, of course, motivation is extremely important and people need to keep appreciating you. But after a point, I think we should go beyond appreciations. We should go beyond all these adulations and stay true to whatever we are doing. If we do whatever we want to do with passion, if we do whatever we want to do with sincerity, I think all of us can have our own 9th symphony in our respective lives, irrespective of whatever.